Hi guys, welcome to Code Decode. So in the previous video, we have covered predicates and functions in very detail. Now today we'll be quickly covering the consumer supplier, by consumer, by supplier, by predicate, by function, if by supplier exists, the streams and parallel streams if time permits. So let me quickly move ahead. So what is consumer function interface? So consumer function interface, let me give you a quick review of what we have read. So predicate, you should take one input, returns boolean. So there is no return type available here. In function, it takes one input and returns one output. Output is not always boolean or some extra explicitly defined return type. That is why we have to use two things in the generic type. That is, one is the input type, one is the return type. It takes one input and one return type is produced after performing some operations on that input. Now, what is consumer? So if you are in, you and me, consider me and you as a consumer. What we do? We actually consume items. Do we ever produce something or do we ever supply? We are not suppliers. We are just consumers. So if we are given something, we will consume it, but we won't return anything. We won't supply anything. So there is no return type. It's only the input type. Basically, predicate used to return boolean. Consumer never returns anything. So that's the difference between predicate and consumer. Functions always return anything. Consumer will never return any boolean or any other return type. It will never return anything. The return type will always be void. So if you can see, the interface consumer takes only one argument. It accepts that argument and returns void. So it returns nothing. Now, let me give you one example before moving ahead. So I'll give you a consumer demo. If I do F3 into it. Okay, sorry. So this is consumer is nothing but a functional interface. This is a predefined functional interface. Again, it's available in rt.jar. See, it's again in rt.jar. So if I say any of these are in existing class, then please understand it is in rt.jar. So this is a predefined functional interface which is having only one abstract method. What is that abstract method? That is a type which is taking a type parameter which we are giving here. It is an accept method. It takes the type parameter and returns nothing because it is a consumer. Consumer never supplies. It only consumes. Now you will be asking, why is it required? Because suppose I'm giving you an object. Suppose I'm giving you a student object. Go and save it in database. So will you return anything? No, you don't need to. You don't require to return me anything. Just do the saving part in database. So it will consume your, basically your method should consume the student object and apply the operation on it. The operation will be saving it to database. Again, it has only one another method apart from the abstract method, which is end then method. If you can see, okay, I'll cover that in upcoming time. Just understand this first, that if it is a consumer, it takes one input. That input is given to accept method. It returns nothing. If this is clear, the next important thing is, what is consumer chaining? So we have seen the functional chaining in the previous video, right? If you remember. So there we had the two ways to consume or to chain. But the consumer has only one method, and then. There also I've told you that it is not required. You can move the C1 here and C2 here. Then also your compose will work same as and then, and the output will be same. So that is why consumer does not have any compose method. It has only and then method. So C1 and then C2 and then apply your input on it. And then again, multiple consumers can be chained with C1 dot and then and multiple. And then you can provide your input to it. The output will be the chain with this particular input. So if you remember this function dot class, it has compose and it has and then. But consumer does not have compose, it has only and then. So if this is clear, let me quickly give you a demo for that. First, let me make you understand what is consumer. So consumer is nothing but a predefined interface. It takes an input integer. What it says, give me an integer and I will put some operation onto your integer, but I'm not going to return anything. I'm just not going to return anything. So we are not putting anything in system.out.println because return type is nothing. So what I am going to do, I'm going to put the system.out.println as a integral part of the operation of this consumer. So this consumer takes 5, it squares and the input taking and performing operation on 5, and I'm going to return nothing. So it just do 5 into 5, that is 25. Again, if this won't have been there, what you would have been doing, you would have been doing a create the consumer demo object and then creating a method into it and then squaring it and then returning it. Simple as that. Now to remove this particular thing, you just need to write it once and then you can use it anywhere with the variable square me and then accept 5. So let me quickly run this for you. So it's taking an input and performing the operations and returning nothing and the value is 25. If that is clear, let me quickly move ahead to consumer chaining. So basically we have read two things. What is consumer? So it's nothing but it takes the input and returns nothing. Now what is consumer chaining? If we have multiple consumers, say suppose square me, double me, then I don't have to do and an operation and then return something. What you can do, you can actually combine or chain the consumers using the and then. So I'm saying first square me and then double me and I'm accepting 5. So 5 will be first squared. So 5 into 5, 25 and then let me run it. So first taking input 25. Because I'm giving 5, so 5 is a 25. And then if I'm giving to double, so this is what I'm giving it to double. If I'm giving double, so 5 will be double and it will be 10. Now, first doubling and then squaring and accepting 5. So taking an input again, the first square me is called and then double me is called. So when square me is called, this particular system.out.println is called and then double me is called. Hence, this is called. So it both takes 5 as an argument. It first squares and says 25 and then it doubles and says 10. If this is clear, the consumer chaining is only that much. One important question which interview may ask you is, what if I do square me.compose? Then it will give you a compile time error because square me is nothing but a consumer and consumer do have and then, but it does not have consume. So if you can see, this particular interface is only having an accept, which is a void and it's an abstract one. And this is a default, which is end, then it does nothing, but it chains. Basically, it does the chaining. So compose does not exist in consumer, but it does exist in functional chaining. So if you would have remembered, we have used end, then and we have used compose. So if this clear, let me quickly move ahead to the next part, which is supplier functional interface. So supplier is going to always supply. It's not going to consume its own thing. So if it is a shopkeeper, it will supply you something. It will return you something. So supplier, it will just supply required objects and will not take any input. It is always going to supply. It's never going to consume or take any input. So if you can see it here, the interface supply is going to have a return type. That return type is nothing but a return type of your single abstract method get, and get is not taking any input. So in consumer we used to take input, right? In consumer it used to take input, return nothing. Supplier is just opposite. It is going to take nothing but return something. Now let me give you an example of supplier first. Supplier demo. So if the supplier function interface would have not been there, what you could have been doing? Creating a supplier object, creating a method which actually returns you the current date and you would have returning new date. Rather than doing this, what you could have been doing? First, let me give you supplier information. Supply is nothing but a predefined dot class file exists in, again, rt.jar package. rt.jar and it is having a @ functional interface, which is why it says that it is only and only one single abstract method. Now this is very important. Please note, there is no static or default method available here. It only has one single abstract method, that is get, that also returns you what the supplier is returning. So there is only return type, there is no input type. So I'm going to, this is going to be a supplier. So this is my supplier for current date. So suppose I want that always return me on current time. This is the current time. So if I'm going to run this, it gives me Monday, 1st Feb. This is the current date. So this is the current date. It's always going to return me the current date. So this is my supplier, which is going to always supply me the current date. So if that is clear for the supplier demo, let me quickly move ahead to the chaining part. So now first assume that how chaining used to be done. Chaining in consumer and supplier is you are taking some input and then you are on that particular input, you are constantly applying multiple functions, multiple consumer predefined function interfaces, multiple functional predefined interfaces. But supplier actually doesn't take any input. So do you really need any of the chaining here? So no chaining is required in supplier functional interface because there is no input given to it. You only have output. So that is why no chaining concept is available in supplier. This is very important. If to confuse you, the interviewer may ask you, how do you do the chaining in supplier functional interface? You should always answer that no chaining is not possible in supplier functional interface because chaining is done when you have one input and you have to do multiple operations, and rather than using different consumers or supply or the consumers or the predicates or the functions, I can chain it together and give one single, in single one line, you can perform multiple operations. But in supplier, we never give input. That is why we don't need any chaining. If that is not clear, please let me know in the comment section. I'll be clarifying that once again to you. Now, again, what is the advantages of supplier? So the same thing. You can write once, you can use anywhere. You can write the supplier, what it does, it always gives you a current date. And in any application program, you can always use that functional interface reference and call your thing without any problem. So this is code reusability. It is write once, use anywhere in a whole program. Now, very important concept. What is the use of by consumer, by function, by predicate, and why there is no by supplier? So the first thing is, till now we have read about predicate. It takes one input. It has one method, which one abstract method it has. It has test method. So it actually returns you Boolean. So what does predicate used to do? Predicate used to check some Boolean condition for you. For that Boolean condition to be written, it needs some input. On that particular input, some operation is done. And if that particular Boolean condition is satisfied, then returns true, else return false. In function, you used to take one input, apply some operation on that input and return something. And the method used there was apply, and then it returns anything, not just Boolean, it can return anything. Consumer, as we have discussed, it takes only input, it consumes it all, it performs the operations, but it's going to return you nothing. Supplier, on the other hand, is nothing but a supplier. It's going to take nothing but return something which is produced by its own operation. So supplier is nothing but it's going to return you something, but never going to take you anything. So this was all about one input returning something or returning nothing. But what if we need two arguments for an operation? Suppose in predicate, what we did, I've given you one string, return me true or false if length is greater than 5. Or else I'm giving you 1, 5, return me 5 into 5, return me the square of it. What if I need two arguments? What if I'm asking you that if I'm giving you 2, 5 and 10, and tell me which is greater, 5 or 10? That is function. Or I'm giving you 2, return whether both are greater than or less than 15. In that case, it needs two arguments. So predicate is not capable to handle two arguments. Function is not capable to handle two arguments. Consumer is not capable to two arguments. Supplier never takes input. So it's capable of handling nothing. That is why no by supplier, because by is always related to number of inputs. Supplier does not take inputs, so there is no reason to create a by supplier interface at all. So that is why you need by functional, by XYZ. By XY, XYZ can be by consumer, by function, by predicate, but never a by supplier. Okay. So there is no input in supplier, so no one or two argument needed, hence no by supplier. Now let me quickly give you an example of what I've explained you till now. So I'm giving you an example here only for by predicate, by function. So by function is basically taking two integers and check the sum of two. So basically what my requirement is, I'm giving you two inputs. Tell me if their sum is greater than 5 or not. So suppose I'm giving you 2 and 5. The output should be true because 2 and 5 gives me 7. 7 is greater than 5. So output should be true. Now I'm giving you two inputs, giving 2 and 1. Does that sum is greater than 5? No, 3 is not greater than or equal to 5. So output should be false. So the first should be true, second should be false. So the first is true, second is false. If this is clear, this is how by predicate works. It takes two integer. And the reference to that is check sum of 2. I'm giving you 2, it's 2 and 5. And then the plus of it should be greater than or equal to. This is a Boolean condition. If you can see, this is a Boolean condition. So that is why by predicate taking two arguments. Now by function, it takes two arguments and returns something because it's not always Boolean. So it's basically a by function is going to take three generic inputs. So that is integer, integer and integer. So multiply both is my function. I want to multiply, I'm giving you two functions, two variables, and please give me a function which actually multiplies both and give me the result. So the result of multiplying two integer will always be an integer because it won't be a double or something, right? It's giving an integer, it will give you an integer. So this is the way to use that, and the way to use your predicate is same, use the test method, and the way to use your function is the same, apply method. So I'm giving you 5 and 10. Please return me the multiplication of all the arguments that I'm giving, the two arguments which I'm giving. So the output should be 50. So this is how the by function, by predicate works. Consumer, you can understand automatically. If you want, I'll create a video for that also, but I assume that it is understandable. So I'm quickly moving ahead to the next question. This is a very tricky question. Interviewer for sure can ask you, what if you have told me about consumer? You have told me about by consumer. What if I want to operate on three arguments? I'm giving you 2, 2 and 2. Return me 2, 3 and 5. Return me the multiplication of all the three. So can we operate on three arguments? Then do we have any try predicate, try consumer, try function? So no, in Java 8. Till now doesn't have any try predicate or try function or try consumer. There is nothing also called as quad predicate, quad function, quad consumer. There is only and only inbuilt functional interfaces which can take only one or two arguments, no more, no try, no quad, nothing, only one and only two. So the only one will be predicate, consumer, function, and the two arguments will be by predicate, by consumer and by function. Supplier will never take an input, so there is one or two argument doesn't comes into picture at all. So no by supplier. Okay, so now I need to move on to streams, but I do not have the time left, so please bear with me. We'll be connecting in the next section with the streams and the parallel streams. Thank you.